Okay students, now we are going to take one more graph. This is the continuation of the previous lecture. A small content, a small which is a of less just 2 to 3 minutes has been left out. We'll be continuing with this one. This is the fraction of the molecules and this is the speed of the molecules, and you are getting the graphs at T1. This one you are getting the graph at T2, you are getting at T3. See, among these three temperature, which one will be the highest? Simple, more is the velocity, more will be the temperature. So this is the speed of T1, this is speed at T2, and this is speed at T3. So automatically T3 will be greater than T2, will be greater than T1. So number of molecules, as you increase, number of molecules are same. Okay, right, as you increase the temperature, what is happening? The curve, whatever this is present at this, it is changing now. Okay, it is becoming, the curve is becoming flattening. And peak, the height, it is getting decreased. So these two you remember students, as the temperature is being increased, the curve gets, see up to here, this one T1, this is T2. This one T1 is there, this is, has been extended with T2. If it is extended, what it becomes, that height gets decreased because the number of molecules are not getting changed. So as the temperature is increasing, the curve is getting flattened and the peak is decreasing. And the area of the curve, what this area of the curve is nothing but the number of molecules. Among these three, the number of molecules are same. Okay, students? Right, let us go for the difference between the ideal gas as well as the real gas. So first time you are coming, right? In ideal gas, if you see, what is the ideal gas equation? PV is equal to nRT. And it says that this gas, any gas or any gas which accepts this equation at all conditions of temperature and pressure, okay, any gas which accepts this PV is equal to nRT at all conditions of temperature and pressure, then that gas is called as ideal gas. But practically, there is no ideal gas, right? For real gas, PV is not equal to nRT. Okay, this is the general equation, but real gas will behave as ideal gas at low pressure. Pressure should be very, 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 very low, and temperature should be very, 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 very high. Okay, when you maintain this condition, real gas will behave as ideal gas, but practically this is possible in the lab only, this type of condition. In our daily life, it is not possible. So all the gases, whatever we are seeing, those are real gases only. Those are not ideal gases, right? Right. Next, going for the ideal gases, molecules of gas have negligible volume. What he is saying is, see, these are the particles. If you release them freely, they will occupy the entire container. Okay, this is the one condition. Another condition, if you get all the molecules closer together and you place at the corner of a container. Okay, so let me assume that this is 10 liters container. Okay, this is also 10 liters container only. Here, what is the volume occupied by the gas molecule? These are free and they are moving in the entire container. They are occupying something like entire volume of the container. So, volume of the gas will be equal to the volume of the container. Okay, now, if you bring all the molecules close together and to one corner of the cube or container, so what happens? The volume, it will be occupying, right? Some volume. That volume, generally it is occupied is 0.00009. 9 ml. So if you compare this one with 10 liters, this is in ml, even it is not 1 ml. So when you compare this space occupied by the tiny particles of the ideal gas, it will be very negligible when compared to the 10 liters volume occupied by the gas molecules. So this can be neglected. So in this case, what we will be telling in terms of ideal gas, the volume of the container is the volume occupied by the gas molecules. That's why we will be taking volume occupied is negligible, it's very small. So volume of the container itself is the volume of the molecules occupying, or they can move in the space, free space that is available in the molecule. See, only this much space in another terms. So if you are freely removing the gas particles and placing here, they will moving in the entire container and they will occupy the entire container place. Okay, so they are having free space to move in the entire container. Suppose if you place here, okay, it is occupying some volume. How much free space is for these molecules? How much free space is available to move in the container? Means it is something like 9.9991 liters. So this is 9.99991 liters. Total space is 10 liters. When you totally they are moving 10 liters, this much volume should be, this much volume should be excluded. And in which volume they are freely moving means this much. When you compare this one with this one, there also it is negligible. So we'll be removing. So approximately this is 10 liters only. Okay, So the volume occupied by the gas molecules in the container is taken as zero in terms of ideal gas. And if you go for here, but practically we will not be having all such type of molecules. If particles are very tiny, then those are real gases, or they are called as point masses. But in real, in practical, the molecules have volume. Means as the molecules are very rigid spheres, they are not the tiny particles. For ideal gas, these are tiny particles or point masses. For here, those are not the particles, those are rigid spheres. Sphere means they will be having volume. What is the volume of the sphere? It is 4/3 pi r cube. So the molecules are like rigid spheres. So in ideal gas, the force of attraction among the molecules will be less, or something we will be calling it as there is no force of attraction. And in terms of real gas, the force of attraction exists between the molecules because the molecules are very bigger in size. See, go for this point. Molecules have volume as molecules are rigid spheres. So let me take, this is 10 liters, same condition whatever I have taken. If I am getting all these together and I am placing, it is occupying some respective volume, right? Let me take, this is occupying something like 2 liters. So what is the available free space for the movement of this molecule? Something like this, 8 liters. 8 liters. In 8 liters volume, these molecules can move. So this 2 liters is not very negligible. It is countable. So it can move in only 8 liters volume. So here the volume cannot be taken as the volume of the container. In this case, in real case, in real gas cases, the available free space is not equal to, is not, this 8 liters is not approximately equal to 10 liters, right? Because the excluded volume is 2 liters. Okay, that's why in real gases, volume of the gas is not equal to volume of container. So volume of the container minus volume occupied by this molecule. If you do that, then you will be getting the volume of this one where they are moving. Okay, students, I think you have got the clarity over these two points. Okay, ideal gas says that there is no force of attraction among the molecules, but real gas says that there are force of attractions among the molecules. Regarding this, we will be getting one equation that is called as Van der Waal equation. We will be dealing regarding that. First, let us complete this. So if you plot a graph, real gases will behave as ideal gases, already I have said, at low pressure and high temperature. See, I am plotting a graph with respect to pressure as well as volume. Okay, this line, whatever I have indicated with the violet color, right? Pressure volume curve, what it will be? According to Boyle's law, pressure volume curve only, no? It will be something like hyperbola you are getting. So A is a ideal gas, you are getting this one. And I am plotting the graph for the real gas, P versus V only. I am getting this dotted line. This dotted line, which is indicated with the brown color. Okay. This violet color, it is indicating the color of the ideal gas for pressure versus volume. And this dotted line with the brown color, it is indicating the pressure versus volume graph hyperbola for the real gas. See, if you go at this condition, at this pressure, at this point of pressure, the pressure of real gas is this one. Sorry, the pressure of ideal gas is this line, whereas the pressure of the real gas is this line. So there is some difference. So it has got from above the axis. So it is having some deviation. So if you see here, at this pressure is constant. If you plot like this, so something like this, you will be getting V1 as well as V2. Among V1 and V2, which is greater? Real gas volume is greater when compared to the ideal gas volume. So at point A, real gas volume is greater than ideal gas volume. Suppose if I take a point here, okay, if I plot the graph, the pressure is constant again here. Now I am taking, this one is the line for the real gas, and this one is the volume for the real gas. If you get here, this one one volume and this one is one volume. Suppose if I take, this is V3 and V4. Okay, which one is greater? Volume of ideal gas is greater than volume of the real gas. If you take at this point, okay, at this point of pressure, volume of ideal gas at this point B, I am taking at this point of B. So volume, this is the volume occupied by the real gas and this is the volume occupied by the ideal gas. So at point B, volume of ideal gas is greater than volume of real gas. At point A, volume of real gas is greater than volume of ideal gas. If real gas is greater than ideal gas, then that is called as positive deviation. Okay, it is above the axis. If you think this as the axis, it is above the axis. And if you take volume of the ideal gas is greater than the real gas, then you will take it as negative deviation. So this is what, how we will be getting deviation of real gas from the ideal gas. Real gas is getting deviated. So this is the graph for ideal gas and this is the graph for real gas. If you plot, if you mix them, what is happening? You are seeing the difference. basically it should be in this pattern if it is ideal gas. But this gas is not ideal gas, so this is real gas, you are having the difference. So this difference, whatever you are getting with respect to ideal gas, it is calculated by using the term called as compressibility factor. So when P is high, when pressure is high, it is positive deviation. When pressure is low, you are getting the negative deviation. And we are going to take one term that is called as compressibility factor. This compressibility factor, it gives the amount of deviation of the real gas. So what type of deviation, whether it is positive deviation or negative deviation, the type of deviation, whatever that is occurring in the molecules, is given by this factor called as compressible factors, right? So, and Z is given by equation PV by RT. Okay, this real volume, whatever that is there, this should be calculated by experimentally. We can't get by theoretically, by calculating on the paper. And whatever the ideal volume, this can, we can calculate. What is the volume of 1 mole of gas, which is ideal? It is 22.4 liters, right? So, ideal gas is, we can calculate. But real gas, we should get experimentally. So, Z is having two formulas. One is PV by RT. You know, no? Already, ideal gas equation PV is equal to nRT. If it is for 1 mole, it is PV by RT. So, if you take PV by RT, it is called as compressibility factor. And Z is also can taken as VR by VI. This is the volume of the real gas by volume of the ideal gas. Generally, real gas volume is calculated experimentally, whereas the ideal gas is calculated by using the PV is equal to nRT equation. If Z is equal to 1, so if bottom and top and bottom are both are equal, means PV is equal to nRT, right? This is PV is equal to RT, means PV is equal to nRT for 1 mole of gas. Then these two are equal, means what does it indicating? It is an ideal gas. So then Z is equal to 1. If Z is equal to 1, it is accepting the equation called as PV is equal to nRT, then the type of gas it is called as ideal gas. If Z is not equal to 1, it may be either greater than 1 or something like less than 1. So, if it is greater than 1, positive deviation. If it is less than 1, we will be calling it as negative deviation. If it is not positive or negative, then it is equal to 1. Then it is ideal gas. So, Z is not equal to 1, that is called as real gas. The equation is taken as PV is not equal to nRT. In this one, Z may be greater than 1 or Z may be less than 1. Right, students? In this way, we will be calculating. So, I am giving one conclusion here. If Z is greater than 1, okay, right, then PV will be greater than nRT. Already you know that Z is equal to PV by nRT. And you know that Z is greater than 1, okay. You take the value of 1. So, Z is greater than 1. In place of Z, you place this one, PV by RT. Greater than 1. And if you take here, PV greater than RT. So, writing this one, if Z is greater than 1, you know that Z is equal to PV by RT or nRT. For 1 mole of gas, it is RT. So, PV is greater than RT if Z is equal to 1, and volume of real gas is greater than volume of ideal gas, Z is greater than 1. If Z is greater than 1, means there is force of repulsion among the molecules. Force of repulsion means what happens? They will occupy the more volume, right? They will occupy the more volume if they are having repulsions. Means what happens if they are occupying more volume means that it is indicating indirectly that the molecules or the gas is expanding. So due to the repulsions, gas expands. Okay, that is positive deviation. If you go for the negative deviation, if it is Z is less than 1, so you take same like Z is less than 1, you know that PV by RT is less than 1 and PV is less than RT. So PV is less than RT and real gas. And you also know that Z is equal to VR by VT. If it is greater than 1, this is the condition. If it is less than 1, this is the condition. Next. Next it is volume of the real gas. It is less than the volume of the ideal gas. Here, if Z is less than 1, the attractive forces dominate. If attractive forces are more, what happens? The molecules will be coming very closer together. So, if they come very close together, what happens? You can easily compress the gas. Okay, students, getting this? Okay, if molecules are coming very closer together, right, those can be easily compressed. Let us complete these questions, these two questions or these three questions, and we'll be stopping for this lecture. At HTP, the volume of 1 mole of gas is measured to be 25 liters. Explain the nature of the gas. So, he is mentioning 25 liters. Right, for 1 mole of gas, and you know that Z is equal to VR by V ideal. 1 mole of gas at HTP conditions, it occupies 22.4. But he has given for this gas it is 25 liters. Okay, liters will be cancelled. 25 by 22.4, definitely it will be greater than 1. So Z is greater than 1. So real gas volume is greater than ideal gas volume. So it shows something like positive deviation. Already we have learned in this set, right? Z is greater than 1. So positive deviation means what is this happening? Repulsive forces are dominant, so volume increases, means the gas is expanding. So I am giving four different types of gases. Gases A, gas B, gas C, gas D. And Z is equal to, for gas A it is 1.4, for B it is 0.8, for C it is 1.6 and D is 0.4. Arrange the increasing order of deviation from the ideal behavior. Okay. Ideal behavior means Z should be equal to 1. Okay. If it is having 0.8, means what it is indicating, it is less than 1. So below the 1 you are writing it as 0.8 for B, and it is C 1.6, it is greater than 1, and going for A it is 1.4 greater than 1, and going for D it is 0.4. So what is asking? Increasing in the order of deviation. So from here to here, 1 to 0.8, what is the deviation? 0.2. from 1 to 0.4, it is 0.6. from 1.4 to 1, it is 0.4. from 1.6 to 1, it is 0.6. So from ideal gas behavior, which is least in deviation here? So from 1 to 0.8, 0.2 is the least deviation. So B will be the less deviation, right? Next one, from 1.4 to 1, 0.4, this is the less deviation. So A is lesser deviation, next one. So if you see, from this one to C, it is 0.6. From this point to D, it is also 0.6. So the deviation of C and D are, both are equal. Okay, I think you are getting, students. So the deviation means, first you should take the individual one, this one as the reference one, and you plot below the one what are there and above the one what are there, and you check the difference between the one as well as the gas, the one as well as the gas. So you are getting 0.4 as well as 0.6, from here to here 0.2 as well as 0.6. This is the lesser deviation, next lesser deviation, these two are same. Okay. See the next question. For the same above graph, this graph only, he is asking, arrange in attractive forces, arrange in order of attractive forces, which will be having the more attractive force. Okay. So what our condition? If Z is less than 1, attractive forces will be dominant. Okay. So among which are less than 1, so less than 1, these two are there. Okay. These two are the conditions which are less than 1. So which is still more lesser? This is still more lesser. So among these two, D will be having more lesser value. Next, going for B, it is Z 0.2 lesser. So these two are attractive. Among these two, if it is greater than 1, what will be having? Well, will be having repulsive forces, right? More is the difference, more will be the repulsive. So among these two, among C and A, this is more in the difference, so this is more repulsive, and going for this one, it is somewhat less repulsive. So this is more, this is less repulsive, so this is somewhat more attractive. So C will be having more amount of repulsive when compared to the A. So A can be easily liquefied. So Z is greater than 1. V real is greater than 1. So gas expands. Z is less than 1. V R means volume of the real gas is less than volume of the ideal gas. So it gets compressed. So this is the condition what we require here. So what he is asking? He is asking attractive forces. Means V R is less than ideal. This equation, this condition is now required, so that you will be getting the answer. So D will be having more attractive compared to B. Next to A, next to See, so this is the order in which we can liquefy. D is more easily liquefied when compared to the remaining gases. Okay, students, this is for today, and tomorrow we will be continuing with the one more topic with respect to graphs of the compressibility factor only. Thank you. Have a nice day and practice the problems, whatever that you are having in your material. All the best.